This guided density planning system, now CACR, we are vigorously promoting this concept. This actually for the system is old system only, 50 years before these Western countries they adopted. And they got a productivity increase and it is suitable for mechanization. They are giving picking machine, it is going everything a mechanized cotton cultivation by adopting this guided density planning system. Now last 10 years I think we want that but 50 in 1967 studies Brieck et al, he only proved that if you select proper germplasm, high density planting system is working in cotton, he proved. So the many countries they have excellent genotype for suitable for high density planting, and it is only system suitable for mechanical picking. So 50 years before they faced labor problem, they went to HDPS, except our India and China, we are concentrating on hybrids. The same time, Kachpur, Chandrakant Patel from Gujarat, he invented Kachpur in 74 time. So we just opposite direction we traveled. When entire country is adopting high density planting system, we adopted lowest density planting system. We adopted a 5,000 plant per acre only. Even our recommendation for PTA capital is one packet, means it is 5,000 seeds only. So actually what we thought it is a heterosis. So heterosis also giving effect. And we got excellent productivity increase by adopting that hybrid also. Now we realized that this type of plant structure, it may not work in for future. Yes, it is highly indeterminate, hybrid. So far, it is not suitable for mechanical picking, where farmer is asking that machine for picking, because it is cost about some 25% to 40% of picking cost is 25% to 40% of final market price. So we cannot continue with this whatever we are giving at present. We are giving that PD hybrid based cottons. So now we have to change our system. CACR we are promoting last 15 years we are promoting. But even though this year only we got high funded, 50 crore funded project, and we are operating this extension project from all 8 cotton growing state. Cotton area, you see the cotton area of Tamil Nadu in India. In 1964, we have 83 lakh hectare only. After introduction of PT cotton only, our area in 2009 only, we got a jump in our area in national level. But in Tamil Nadu, actually except Tamil Nadu, all other states, after introduction of PT cotton, we observed significant area increase, except Tamil Nadu. Here the problem is all other states, the Kelligorbar, the Pollam is the major problem. Here labor is the major problem. So when this PT cotton is not solving labor problem, so our farmers are not showing any interest. But throughout the country, its area is increased from 83 lakh hectare to 125 lakh hectare, entire national figure. For Tamil Nadu, it is reduced 3.8 lakh hectare to 0.7. Actually, I refer that 100 years old literature of Imperial Council of Agriculture, is our present ICR report. They reported that 16 lakh acre in Piyan Madurai, they are telling, southern district of Tamil Nadu, Madras Presidency, it is, they reported 120 years before area of cotton. Now we have only 10% only. Almost we lost all the area. It is all arboreum, sir. 100 years before, fully arboreum only. 1964-65 only, that chrysotom slowly they started. Now almost we replaced the arboreum only in chrysotom is going on. Now 90%, 8% of area PT hybrid only. It is adopted. But in Tamil Nadu, actually what we analyzed that wherever irrigation facilities they created, so whenever the irrigation facility is created, they refuse to adopt cotton. For typical example of Lower Bhavani project is the World Bank funded project, notified crop is cotton only. Before project, they are cultivating cotton as a rainbed crop. So government actually they made dam. But after getting water, they stopped to cultivate the cotton. So because under irrigated condition is the ornamental crop, under rainbed condition only is the ruling crop. Because of this region only, even though Tamil Nadu government is a priority crop, national priority crop, but in Tamil Nadu, we have a lot of area also. 8 lakh hectare is highly suitable for cotton cultivation in Tamil Nadu. Another 25 lakh hectare is with some limitation only. But if you see the Maharashtra, 40 lakh hectare is suitable, they are cultivating, but maximum area is shallow soils. Cotton one like a deep rooted soil, deep rooted crop like heavy soils with a deep soil. But this mismatching, where we are, there is a soil and a climate based, the crop is suitable area, we are not cultivating, where it is not recommended, sizable area in the country, it, we are cultivating at. Because of the reason only, we are, our productivity is always low. But in other countries, independent systems. If you take US, they are cotton belt, maize belt like that. Even some other countries, they are, all technology adoption is voluntary, like Egypt. Once they selected the crop, they cannot go for all varieties. Only government dictated, this is the variety for particular district. So they have this type of compulsion. But here, there is no our fully democratic system. We are not a technology election is voluntary nature. Where here, our the Lower Pawnee project area, after water, they stopped to cultivate. But the unknown, these regions, they are cultivating cotton. The recommended crop is sorghum only. But comparatively, it is giving better economics for farmers want to go for cotton. This this type of situation only, our productivity is always low. So straight away, we cannot compare our productivity with USA or China, like our Director General, I always tell, we have to compare with comparable. Not like, we have to compare with our own productivity only. Because we have a lot of this mismatching. So straight away, we cannot compare with USA or China or other part of the country. This is the percentage contribution of Tamil Nadu area to a national level. This keep on declining. One of the reasons is our year, we are promoting crop diversification, except rice, groundnut, and coconut. Remaining, we have 25 crop, 1 lakh hectare only, like cotton. So, but for cotton is a priority crop for Tamil Nadu government also. Here, our consumption is more than 125 lakh pearls. Our production is less than 5 lakh pearls. We are taking from Maharashtra and Gujarat, and these our mills are paying by at least 500 to 700 rupees extra per tax and fuel charges for taking cotton from Maharashtra and Gujarat per quintal. This is the production also. Almost in 1964-65, the national production is 60 lakh pearls. Now we reached, or in between, we reached 2012-13, 317. Now we reached 316 only. Tamil Nadu from 5 lakh pearls we made, now it reached very minimum level. Our consumption is 125 lakh pearls. We are 1% only we are contributing. Our mills are taking from other place. The problem is here, whatever ginning mill we are giving, they are not able to operate. It is employment opportunity also we are missing. So one of the reason for why we want to promote high density planting system is, it is a productivity wise we observed in many countries, it is a two-fold, three-fold, sometimes four-fold increase in productivity by adapting that high density planting system. So now after introduction of PT card, we observed from 300 to 550 it reached. So again, now it is coming to 429. Every year we are releasing 50 PT hybrid, but there is no break. So now we realized that we have to change some agronomy technology by genetic. And now we have the some, they all fermentation competition already they made. So nothing is new, germplasm is there. So it is not going. So this agronomy technology, high density planting system, now we are thinking that is the only way we have to increase our productivity. We can make that is palm per machine harvest. This is our productivity, national and Tamil Nadu productivity. Except last few years, otherwise our productivity is always higher as compared to remaining the national productivity. But you see the typical example of Brazil, up to 91-95, the productivity is 385 kg only. So 2010, within 15 years, the productivity reached 1,443 by adopting the single technology, high density planting system, four-fold increase of productivity in Brazil. Now they are cultivating one-third of the area. They are telling that it is more than sufficient for them, and they are producing more than what they produced 20 years before. So fourfold increase the productivity we observed in a high density planting system. After seeing that Brazil experience only, our director he visited, and 2012 we thought that this may be suitable for us also. We promoted high density planting system. The reason is for the last 15 years, we observed that there is no increase in the productivity. It is successfully adopted in many countries. Again, 60 to 70% of photos is that this crop is putting into morpho frame only. So if you reduce that size, ultimately we can put my, take more harvest index. So automatically it's the yield. These are so many advantages are there. It is, we can reduce the duration, high light interception, more effective leaf area, harvest index is more, more productivity and profitability. But we cannot say in all the place, all advantages, we cannot generalize. But at least one or two advantages are wherever we are promoting this technology. But that same technology is wherever high fertility condition it is, because we now we are giving varieties which is released for high density planting system. Earlier 10 years, 15 years before, we started with our conventional genotypes. So it is wherever high fertile soil, very difficult to manage the crop. Liberia is going for more than 12. This is a problem with HDPS. This is a typical rainfall pattern of central zone and whenever monsoon strike, it is continuous rain for two and a half months only. Then there is no rain. But if you see the cotton water requirement, high density planting system, we are comparing with PT hybrid. At earlier stage, water logging or excess moisture, when the crop need pole formation stage, pole formation stage, the crop is suffering for want of moisture. But as comparatively, if you see that the high density planting, early compact genotypes, here it is reaching squaring and flowering earlier as compared to hybrid. So here the water utilization point of view, here this sky, again the stress is less at the time of pole and pole posting time. This moisture requirement as compared to hybrid is less. So this actually it is not perfectly matching. It is comparatively better than hybrid with respect to rainfall pattern. Yeah, this almost same rainfall pattern throughout the country except the western zone of Tamil Nadu, so northwestern zone of Tamil Nadu and southern transition zone of Karnataka, where they are getting two season rain. Otherwise, this is the nowhere we are getting for 5 months rainfall. Actually, we want ideal plant type. The what we are giving hybrid is totally not suitable for this plant. So ideal plant type means it should be a 1 meter height, because the machine is not picking more than 1 meter height. I mean, 20 cm, symbolia start from more than 20 centimeter above, because the machine is not picking 20 centimeter below. So this again, for if you take symbolia, 5 centimeter to 15 centimeter maximum. So with this maximum, say 60 centimeter only allowed, this compact plant. These are the conditions, no monopodia, and it is resistant to all pest and disease, short early duration. These are the conditions, it is our ideal type for high density planting system. This, you see the photograph, this is our CCR variety, which is released for high density planting system. You see that no symbolia is only 5 centimeter symbolia. Direct pairing is not possible because of it is a morphology pattern. Botanically, it's not allowing. So at least we need a small symbolia, 5 centimeter symbolia. You see this photograph, plant type we want for high density planting system. Actually, this agronomy studies we studied, we published in Indian Agriculture Sciences. The compactness, high density planting system means that compactness. It is a for predatory petal qualitatively, they tell like a 100 centimeter symbolia length other thing. For agronomic point of view, we have to quantify that effect. Suppose thousands of germplasm is there, now we have to screen the germplasm or you have to compare the treatments. So we analyzed the cotton is anatomically, morphologically, it is a cone structure. It's easy that here, this also. It starts, it is erect and indeterminate spiral shaped. But first symbolia or monopodia start from this the maximum length where symbolia is at base. Again, it's proportionately decreasing towards the top. So this structure is making cone. Again, if we say the face here, always we recommend that elliptical face, not circular. Because one side row we are keeping 90 and plant 30 we are keeping. So the perpendicular to row, the symbolia length is more. This adjacent side is symbolia length is less. Because of this structure, we are getting elliptical phase. So mathematically, if we calculate pi r squared, pi to small r into capital R. Capital R means highest symbolia length, day small. For volume, if we calculate, it is a cylinder. So 1 pi theta pi r squared. கேபிட்டல் ஆர் அண்ட் ஸ்மால் ஆர். பை திஸ் வே வி மேட் டூ இண்டெக்ஸ், ஒன் இஸ் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த ஏரியா, வாட் ஆக்சுவல் ஏரியா கம்பேர் வித் இண்டிவிஜுவல் பிளான்ட், அனதர் இஸ் வால்யூம் ஆஃப் சைஸ் ஆஃப் த பிளான்ட். ஹியர் வி கம்பேர் வித் அக்ரானமி ட்ரீட்மெண்ட், மேபி பர்டிகுலர் ரெட் அப்ளிகேஷன் டூ டைம்ஸ் ஒரு சிங்கிள் டைம். யூ சி தட் ஏரியா இஸ் இப் யூ அப்ளை மேபிகாட்டோட கண்ட்ரோல் 920 சென்டிமீட்டர் ஸ்கொயர், ஹியர் 782, 581. இப்போ இப் யூ அப்ளை த மேபிகாட் கூட த சைஸ் ஆஃப் த பிளான்ட் இஸ் ரெடியூஸ்டு காம்பேக்ட். So it, we can perfectly we can tell that this is the area covered by the plant. Percentage of reduction also we reported. Volume, if you see the volume of the plant also sizably reduced. That compactness efficiency index for control 12.9, for baby cut cooler one time applied 17, it is 24, which is a more compaction is more. So by this way only we have to assess the treatment, or we have to screen the jam blossom for pneumatic planters. Actually it need two labor only per PT cable, but it is a 6-time intensification of cropping, so it need at least 12 labor per any labor intensive technology we cannot promote. So we studied all cultivated mounted seed drill, cotton seed drill, pneumatic seed drill, all mechanical. Both two types are there, only pneumatic, one is mechanical type. So pneumatic is always a vacuum cleaner type. So it sucks the seed perfectly and places the seed perfectly. For mechanical planters, jerking is we cannot avoid. So the omission and doubling always there. Here it is not possible. Here it is perfectly matching. We are taking single seed and perfectly deployed. We can go for sowing of carrot seed also by pneumatic planter. Pneumatic planter is perfect, but the only thing is costly. The foreign made is 12 lakh, but the Indian made are available 3 to 5 lakh. per machine. Now for our NFSM project, we are going to provide each machine for each KVK for to promote the technology. This Rossi seeds trial we conducted. We are comparing the farmer's practice with high density planting system in all sowing type, February, March or April. Again, we remove monopodia removal and PGR spray. In all situations, the high density planting system is giving a significantly higher yield as compared to farmer practice. This is our CACR trial, light interception. Actually, RCH2 BT is we have shown by 1860. Remaining are high density planting system. Use the light interception is for RCH2 BT 17%, remaining 4 times or 5 times higher for high density planting system. Here also, for you take yield at the time of after releasing a PT hybrid, we saw that none of the non-PT hybrid is giving equal yield, because PT is giving edge over 30 to 40% extra yield. Here we and we same make high density planting system. RCH2PT we called 18 quintal, others are 21 or 25 quintals. So 30 to 40% extra yield by high density planting system, by same economics also, 14 into 4, it is 20 mm length, so it is poor. Otherwise, this economics calculated 10 years before. It is telling that high density planting is more profitable than our PT cable. This is our experiment, another one experiments. Here we selected the compact HDBS varieties and three agronomy, 60 into 30 plus RDM, 45 into 15, high density planting, 45 into 15 plus 125. We found that for conventional 10 quintal would be 14 quintal and almost 15 quintal. But within the genotypes, some genotypes, especially Suraj and PKV081, CNH281, and this ADP, these genotypes are highly performing, highly suitable for high density planting system. Here we reported 67% higher in Suraj, 44% in PKV081, 34% in CNH281. And so this some genotypes are, it is because genotype interaction, it is some selected genotypes are performing well under high density planting system. Actually, we are that earliness we are claiming that HDP is coming, but this genotype we have not observed any earliness. It is non-significant only. The seed cut is data pictorial representation. You see that 45 into 15 centimeter, almost all genotypes, and especially Suraj and PKV081, CNH281, we observed that excellent performance of HDPS. N utilization efficiency here also, straight away we cannot conclude it is HDPS giving, but some of the genotypes, if you take Suraj, M1 is less N utilization efficiency, same time M3, that modified agronomy, high density planting agronomy is giving more nitrogen use efficiency. Finally, we promoted Suraj only. We avoided all other crops. Carvest index also same. It is we cannot generalize all the genotypes, but some of the genotypes, CNH1109 and Suraj, we found that carvest index are more with HDBS. This arboreum trial, arboreum we tried 3 agronomy with different arboreum genotypes, 60 into 30 with recommended nutrients, 45 to 10 with 45 to 10 with 125%. Here we observe that average yield of 8 kundal. Here the HDBS is giving 3 kundal, at least 4 kundal extra yield. So in arboreum also this high density planting system is the same data with pictorial presentation. We see that the interaction, the genotype interaction is there. CNA 404 and JLA 505, these arboreum genotypes are highly suitable for HDBS. N utilization efficiency also we observed some of the genotypes giving more utilization efficiency under HDBS. Carvest index also, this were here we are comparing conventional planting of same genotypes with high density planting system. Anjali, Suraj, we observed that Anjali with conventional planting, we observed under irrigated condition 18.8 kundal, almost double by adopting high density planting system. This both rainfed and irrigated condition also, high density planting system, we observed that more economics and more yield. So this system is not only for rainfed, it under irrigated system also, it is calnutrient. So I mean, actually we are promoting for rainfed only, but under irrigated system also, this technology is working. This trial already our iCrip trial. I am the PA of the iCrip. High density planting system are different PT varieties. So we observed that North Zone, where in Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, PT variety 3, we observed almost better performance with respect to high density planting system. 67.5 into 15 centimeter, we observed better in many places. Same experiment in Central Zone. Where the Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat and Orissa, we observed the Rajat PT, and in many times Rajat PT is performing better than other varieties with respect to agronomy. 60 and 15 centimeter of high density planting is better under in many places. This is our experiment LH 900. At the time of 15 years, we are not giving exclusive variety for high density planting system. But whatever available genotype for rice, fallow cotton, we selected from our MCO7, KC3, and from like North Indian varieties we collected. This compact, basically it is compact early duration. It is almost similar to high density planting system only. Only thing, the purpose is different. So at the time, we conducted the LS900, NS615, PKV081, KC3 of Koil Petty, Anjali. The Sarnam is one of the arboreum, like different species we studied, yes, in Nagpur. This also we observed that it is a better performance under a high density planting system. This Rasi, now all private companies, they are giving compact PT hybrids. They are telling that 6 packet per acre, it is sufficient, 90 into 15 centimeter. Wherever it is not compact, we are recommended for closer planting of 90 into 30 also, because we are not able to supply seeds. Only private companies, once if you approve, only they will supply, they will take care. Now they are vigorously promoting high density planting system, because they know that once it is adopted, government variety genotypes, they may not like private genotypes. So they also changed their mind, and they are giving all, every company, they are giving 2-3 excellent types. And now, this is finally, for our NFSM project, we concluded that HDBS for want of intercultural operation, so many agronomy consideration, 90 into 50 centimeter for high density planting for private compact hybrids, 90 into 30 centimeter, 30,000 plant, here 15,000 plants, yellow soil for HDBS, median high petal soil for this closer planting we are promoting. For this pneumatic planters, actually for want of labor scarcity and other thing, pneumatic planter only, we are supplied pneumatic planter also. For soil test based nutrient, otherwise 25% extra nutrients for this high density planting, we saw that many places it need reported 25% extra nutrients. So accordingly, we all our findings, so many experiment, we concluded that ஒன் தேர்ட் ஆஃப் த நைட்ரஜன், த்ரீ ஸ்பிளிட் பர் பொட்டாசியம் டூ ஸ்பிளிட், பாஸ்பரஸ் சச் 100% பேசன், தீஸ் ஒன்லி வி ரெக்கமெண்டட் பார் போஸ்ட் எமர்ஜென்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. பிரி எமர்ஜென்ஸ் சேம் பெண்டிமெத்திலின் வி கேன் யூஸ், அண்ட் போஸ்ட் எமர்ஜென்ஸ் ஹிட்விட் மேக்ஸ் சேம் வாட் எவர் வி ஆர் ரெக்கமெண்டிங் பார் பிடி கேபிள், சேம் திங் வி கேன் அப்ளை பார் ஹெச்டிபிஎஸ் ஆல்சோ. ஹியர் திஸ் கேனபி மேனேஜ்மெண்ட், ஹியர் இஸ் பார் கன்வென்ஷனல் டைப் கேனபி மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் வி ஆர் நாட் கன்சர்ன். பட் இப் யூ டேக் ஆஸ்திரேலியன் கிராப் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் கைடு, தே ஆர் ரெக்கமெண்டிங் 7 times கேனபி மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் தே ஆர் கிவிங் ப்ரியாரிட்டி. பார் இன் அவர் பிளேஸ் வி டோன்ட் ஹவ் நவ் ஒன்லி வி ஆர் கேவிங் சம் க்ரோத் ரிட்டார்டன்ட். ஆக்சுவலி பார் வாட் அவர் பிளான் பிஜிஆர் 6-7 கெமிக்கல் நவ் வி ஆர் கேவிங் இன் அவர் மார்க்கெட் பார் எஸ்பெஷலி பை தி சூட்டபிள் ஃபார் காட்டன். ஸோ தி ஸ்டாப் 5 nodes யூ எக்ஸப்ட் லீவிங் டெர்மினல் நோட் வி ஹவ் டு கவுண்ட் ஃபஸ்ட்டு 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5 இந்த ஃபஸ்ட்டு 5 node லென்த் இன்டர்நோட லென்த் வி ஹவ் டு மெஷர். Once it is crossing 20 centimeter means so it is non-compact, it is going different direction, so it need compaction, so we have to apply the chemical. Suppose it is entirely compact means no need to spray anything, and this conclusion for this foreign literature also they are telling almost similar result only. For our condition also we standardized this. You see that your top 5 is less than 20 means no need of growth radar. Here it is going more than 20, so it need Mebicard chloride application. For Mebicard chloride also we studied so many experiments, we recommended 1 ml per initially per 45 days crop. Again we have to measure after 15 days. If it is crossing more than 20, again one more dose, or in sad also, so 3 times we have to apply the Mebicard plant growth retardant for canopy management. Otherwise leaf area index was sometime in 14 also. Because of high leaf area, the sucking bust problem, pole rot, and this all problem is coming. So this canopy management density planting system. You see the Mebicard chloride applied field and this control plot. Once the Mebicard chloride, it is helping for yield increase also, because it is inducing the flowering and it is reducing the size of the leaf, internodal length, and is making that open canopy. So there is no less problem of sucking bust. Again, there is no problem of pole rot. So it is secondary metabolite concentrations are getting increased. So because of that, we are getting less sucking bust whenever we are spraying with Mebicard chloride. It looks like tarquin, but sucking bust problem is less. This again, different genotypes we sprayed Mebicard chloride. In control, you see the 15.3 with Mebicard chloride, 15.3 kundal, here 13.3, 2 kundal extra advantage by Mebicard chloride application. Here also we observe that with the genotype which are tall, non-compact, it is need, it is responding better, especially University DCH1608, KC3, 1707 by, it need Mebicard chloride. Whenever we are applying this one, it is responding very well with Mebicard chloride application. This same canopy management tried in iCrep experiments. We are actually we need more foliage. So purposefully we created 20-50% more nutrients to create that more foliage. Then we applied our treatments. Here you see that application control as compared to control, 3 to 4 control extra advantage by Mebicard chloride application of 20 gram at 60 and 75 days after sowing in many of the ASRB centers they reported. Fastest for rain bed crop, soil moisture conservation of broadbed furrow, in a random dye reaching or HSL furrow, this thing we have to follow, otherwise yield reduction will be there. This cost of action, one of the reasons why we want to promote the technology, means already I told that the, if you see that the cost of cultivation is from 88,000 C3, if you include all variable cost, pit depreciation, fixed cost and managerial cost, almost 1,25,000. We take variable cost, it is my average of 75,000 only. The picking cost is almost 20,000 rupees. So if we take variable cost, the percentage is nearly 20-25% of the cost of cultivation is going for picking cost only. Picking cost for different places almost 10-12, because it is now we are promoting the PT gabble, it is 7-8 gram pole weight. In 20 years before, our genotypes are 3.5 gram, 2.5, 3 grams. Nowadays, we cannot promote our genotypes because no labor is not liking. Labor is not coming for picking. So they are telling if you take suvin or other crop, per kg they are paying 35-40 rupees per picking cost. But price is 160 rupees per kg. But picking cost, because of this private company, they are keep on promoting a big pole component. Otherwise, now almost cotton farming will be stopped. It will reach 30-40 rupees, and again disposal rate is 60 rupees only. So 80% of cost is going for picking cost, means automatically they would have stopped. But these companies, they know the problem, so they keep on releasing new hybrid. They started about 4.9, now 6, 7, 8 gram pole weight also there. Because otherwise, they do have one problem only. So this thing also farmers are telling it is more costly. So we want to go for mechanical picking. Kachadi is the only way. Otherwise, it is synchronous pole busting. Synchronous means cotton is basically indeterminate and it's a tree only. So it almost comparatively synchronous busting is there. But it need a defoliant. Just like that machine, we cannot allow. So it need, like Western countries, we need defoliant. We have to shed all the leaves, everything we have to shed except a bowl, open board. So we don't do, unfortunately, we don't have any defoliant. Now only we are making and we are preparing defoliants. Here this diazoran plus diuron combination, we observe that defoliation 94.4%. There is leaf area index after 10 days, zero. It means no leaf is available. Pole opening is 92 because it is, we have to apply 60% of normal opening. Otherwise, immature pole also get opened and it will spoil the quality parameter. So once it is a 60% is opened, means we have to apply the defoliant. For pole weight and seed cotton yield also, here data is not coming. Here only maximum yield is in T12 only. However, if you apply proper time, actually if all green ball, if you apply defoliant, it affects the quality parameter because all immature ball also it is forced to open. So but once 60% ball opening is there, if you apply, means there is no problem of quality parameter also. This is our field, you have applied defoliant. Last time here also, last week they brought machine, same machine we also brought. So it is picking, no problem. Only thing, we have to have some 20 centimeter above Symbodia, 100 centimeter. Again, they no riches, they are asking flat feds. So in riches and borrow means it is not taking. Defoliant, proper defoliation must, these all conditions are available. Moreover, the machine is 10 ton. So it's optimum soil moisture must, otherwise it will compact supply soil. Again, it need 1 crore. These all problems are there. Once almost agronomically we standardized everything. Pre-cleaning, no pre-cleaning process available in the country. It need, actually in foreign countries also, they are harvesting to 30-40% trash only. But before ginning, they are having pre-cleaning process. Here, our cotton is manually picked, we don't have any pre-cleaning process. Last TMC project, government provided budget to these all private people. They asked to cover pre-cleaning process. They all certificate that they established everything. But now they are telling they don't have pre-cleaning process. So again, you need some machinery for pre-cleaning process. Right away, we cannot take to any factory. Now the problem is, who will bear the cost of pre-cleaning? So industry is telling industry cannot do. Only farmers. Farmers, if pay means, including defoliant, as pre-cleaning means almost equivalent to manual picking only. So who will pay this all controversy going up? Almost government is very sincere about fixing everything within 2-3 years. Again, they are going to provide DMC project, Kaili funded. They are going to make pre-cleaning process with all ginning factory. Once the CACR also, we are giving machine. The Saktiman, John Deere, they are also giving machines. Almost problem is solved. Now we have PT with compact genotypes, agronomy, physiology, except defoliant. Remaining things are all, everything is available in the country, including machine also. It is almost Kachadi BSC is ready. This radar, we are promoting this concept also because now we are organic carbon content is very less. We can incorporate this almost 2 ton of cotton stock. At least it provides 20 kg of nitrogen, 2 kg of P2O5 and 12 kg of K2O in addition to that organic cotton, organic carbon improvement. This almost minimum we observe 20% yield advantage in under any situation. Sometimes we saw the double 2.4 fold also. So it is rare. We cannot generalize rare cases. Just like that, we cannot promote it. So it may not work. ஸோ தௌசண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் டமோ வி சிஎஸ்ஆர் கண்டக்டட் த்ரூஅவுட் த கண்ட்ரி. மினிமம் 30% 15 days எலினஸ் இஸ் தட் திஸ் எலினஸ் வி கேன் யூஸ் இட் ஃபார் கிராப்பிங் சிஸ்டம் ரபி பல்சஸ் வி கேன் ப்ரொமோட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ஏர்லி மெச்சூரிட்டி எஸ்கேபிங் ஃப்ரம் ஒன் பிங்க் போல்வாம் அட்டாக் ஆல்சோ. தீஸ் ஆர் த சேலஞ்சஸ் ஆஃப் ஹை டென்சிட்டி பிளான்டிங் சிஸ்டம் இஸ் அவைலபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் த டிஃபாலியன்ட் வேர் இந்தியா தே ஒன்லி ப்ராட் திஸ் கெமிக்கல் இன் பிட்வீன் சம் லீகல் லிட்டிகேஷன் ப்ராப்ளம் தே ஸ்டாப்டு. So at most now we are physically we don't have, we are getting chemical for research purpose only. At present we don't have anything in the our country, but many people are serious about this. Soon anything it may be available again for this mechanical picker. It's a small 0.5 acre 1 acre again without the road facilities. This machine we have to take harvester, this all problem is there. Initial investment 1 crore, so the planter is 13 lakh and the picker is 1 crore. This all things are there. Again, rainfall pattern, this natural now climate change nowadays, we are getting rain at any time. This problem is, suppose we have field is ready for heavy rain come, you cannot pick the field. These things are, it is practical difficulties are there. This 50 crore funded project, not only this technology, in addition to the 3 technology we are promoting. First year we are promoting Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, 34 district we are promoting this high density planting system. And the government is providing, central government is completely sponsored by Government of India, 16,000 rupees per hectare. And we have one machine per serrator and one planter. We are every KVK we are providing, every 100 acre one YP1, one YP2, one REA, 4 training program, one Kisan Mela and so many, 50 lakh, nearly 60 lakh rupees we have, one KVK we are paying per 100 acre demonstration. Almost 1 lakh per demo. Highly funded project, it is going on. Almost we are getting excellent result from throughout the country. In many places we recorded 21 kundal, 25 kundal, 18 kundal. In Tamil Nadu also 12 kundal, 14 kundal per acre. Per acre we are getting by this technology this year. Next year actually government wants that the entire country we are going to promote this KCD-based demonstration. Only this thing, actually this CSR last 15 years we are promoting, only this year only we saw that farmers adopted the technology because we brought the technology in with the private JM platform, with the PT background. When PT is in peak in adoption, we promote a non-PT based technology. Proved that it is working, but farmers don't want other than PT. But first this time almost all, next year I think it will almost very demand will be there for seed, the high density planting system, compact genotypes. Almost in all the place, 18 kundal, 20 kundal per acre recorded. With this all, we got cooler head, planters, picker, everything we promoted holistically. Another 2-3 years government they are going to extend the project for another 2 years also. Our Palaji also working the same project only. Actually, I am PA for the project. Actually, we planned 63 districts. This was 34, another 2 technology from Rajasthan to Tamil Nadu we are giving. KVK we are promoting this technology. Thank you. If you have any specific queries, I will answer.
So we understand it is very challenging task to work on cotton. But when farmers start knowing that there is no other option and cotton is a very remunerative crop, like how they adopted for sugarcane and rice, then they will also start picking up before you could recommend. They will automatically come forward. But it has to pick up. That is the main problem. So now from your lecture, we are coming to know how drastically the area under cotton has reduced in spite of so many mills in cotton. We being the South Indian Manchester and all that, we, I think slowly we lose the name also.
So the Tamil Nadu government, they are priority crop is cotton, but cotton. Unfortunately they are not supporting that PT cotton policy, PT transgenic policy. So they are not promoting, they are not interfering with any extension or but research they are not doing. This is very thing, these things are not supporting. Finally they are recommending non-PT type of seeds, so nobody is adopting.
Yes.
So the last is 15 years by extension, they are not able to convince the government. Once they accepted, still they are continuing with the same policy only. They have to change. Now, again, for at the time of 2002-03, when we introduced the PT cable, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and Telangana, sizable area is increased.
Except rest of the country, more than 90% is only under BT, is it not?
Yes, 98%. 98%
is BT only. But only Tamil Nadu is not adopting.
Tamil Nadu in the area is reduced. The reason is, Tamil Nadu the problem is labor scarcity, not long, the second problem. The first foremost problem for other places is carryover only. So they adopted straight away. Here our problem is, now we are solving that problem. Now we have mechanized sowing, precision farming, drip irrigation, again drone spray, guidance, again guidance did that herbicide resistant RRF we are going to pre, government is going to approve. So once they approve, means the glyphosate based weed control, it is easier. The by drone spray we can control. Man, now this almost able and mechanical picking, everything ready. So vigorously government of India is promoting for this concept. I think within paper our retirement, I think things will be changed. Our entire way of operating farm will be different, especially for cotton. Like, because the cotton is not mechanized as compared to other crop, like rice or wheat or soybean or maize. I mean, we never thought rice mechanization. But the cotton, yes, it is having that problem of indeterminate plant. So picking is not so easy. So we have to change the genome loss. Everything we have to change. From even whatever genome loss we are giving, not suitable. So we are not able to throw that selected plants. Last 30, 40, 50 years, we used that plant. It is responded well for irrigation to increase the productivity. Straight away, if we throw our planner policy, they are afraid that sometime it may not work. Identity planting means we cannot import our cotton. So this whatever we are giving is working. Only thing is for mechanical picking is not suitable. Farmers are not ready. This problem is coming. So almost now we decided everything. All both the textile ministry and government of India, agriculture ministry, both the secretary only, they are only supporting. They visited all the places. We convinced, and the next year they are going to fund 500 crore. So we are going to promote the concept vigorously throughout the country.
Okay. Dr. Another one more doubt. Instead of shredding and everything, we can cut close to the ground. Whether we can allow for regrowth?
No. Actually, the problem is ratoon studies, so many times we studied. We proved that no need of cutting ground. You allow 2 feet.
Then
prune it all side. And it is giving 40 to 50% yield. With our
any cost involved?
No, actually, without, you can reduce the duration 2.5 months. Within 2 months, 3 months, you can take another 40-50% yield. The problem is the pink pollen is severe creating. Now almost PT is not able to control. If you allow that extended growth period, so the severe pink pollen attack, again it is continuing for next year will be more. This was because of this problem only we are not promoting that ratoon type. Otherwise, our physiologist, Dr. Kadar, he studied entire ratoon studies only. He told that it is more remunerative than a new crop. Farmers also, what they are doing, they don't want to remove the crop first. The problem is, we are telling 5 months, 6 months, they want to remove. But what they are doing, it is single crop system. They are keeping the crop up to 10 months. Whatever, and because the new PT chemicals are giving some 5 gram, 6 gram in top also. Otherwise, our genotype 2 gram means they may not show any interest. So it is 5 gram, 6 gram means farmers also, they are keeping. They are telling it is, if you keep 8 months, 10 months only, it is giving 14 quintal, 15 quintal. 5 months, if you close, only 10 quintal. So even a drip irrigation now, the drip irrigation, the extended growth period, it is helping for extended growth period. Even the germplasms, the PT germplasm, it is also helping for extended growth period. Suppose it is a top pole is coming 2 gram, means nobody is so interested. So again, it is coming 5 gram, 6 gram, 7 gram, up to 180 days. So these all farmers are, they don't want to stop the crop. But another side, we have to see that the pink ball is a major problem. It is creating, we are not able to control. Because of this only, we are asking to cut the crop. And once we are going asking to go for the second crops.
So in Athur area, farmers are retaining the crop to cut 2 centimeter or 2.5 feet height. They are allowing for regrowth also. Because one more problem is stem weaving.
Actually, the problem of stem weevil because of in Tamil Nadu only, now it has never crossed even Karnataka once we noticed, otherwise only it is specific to Tamil Nadu only. Winter irrigator, winter rain bed, and summer irrigator, rice fallow cotton, because of this continuous inoculum is available. So this stem weevil is ruling. Otherwise, there is no problem in North India. So in the high density planting system, Madurai, Theni, Uthalambattu area, they adopted 100 years before. What they are telling, because of stem weevil only. So it severe incident of stem weevil, almost it taking 50% of population. So if you put 6 kg or 8 kg, so they are even to take 50% population also, they are giving a sizable population for yielding. So they are telling this only system is working here, at least 7 to 8 quintal acre. Some of the innovative farmers that tried PT capability, finally it is stem weevil has taken almost 70%, 0.5 quintal only per acre they harvested. Some private companies they promoted, they told that it may not work your system, and now we have PT in it. So some innovative farmers they planted, they are telling that almost stem weevil has taken everything. So this high density planting, wherever problem is, yellow soil or marginal land, stem weevil problem, Telangana, Palaji has not come, I went to sandy soils. Sandy soil also it is giving 12 quintal acre. Otherwise, normally 3 to 4 quintal only. Because in the marginal, wherever abiotic stress is there, biotic pressure is there, this high density planting system is working. And this time we visited in Karnataka, only first soaking rain. There is no rain. But the soil is 9 feet. They are harvested 5 to 6 quintal. For conventional, only 1 to 2 quintal only. This extreme condition technology is working very well. Thank you.
Okay, Doctor. Thank you.